Either it's for yourself, your company, your clients, you're most likely managing a few different social media pages. That means a whole lot of data to track. Hey marketers, it's Edward from the DashThis team, and today we wanted to show you how to create a social media analytics report easily. When you work on social media strategies, you want to know which posts perform better, which channel is worth putting more effort into, how many subscribers, comments, or even likes you've got. There's a lot going on. And usually, it takes so much time to gather all of these social media analytics from Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and all those other channels. If you're going around each and every social page, copying and pasting your data into a boring and not sexy PowerPoint, or even worse, a Google Sheet, please stop. Stop, seriously, stop. You're not a grandma. And no offense to grandmas out there. I've seen some do pretty cool stuff, pretty cool reporting stuff, I mean. But it's not productive. So let's be productive instead and use a tool that helps marketers. So let's create a social media analytics report. Here's how I personally create my social media reports. And feel free to copy me. That's what this video is for. So first, I choose a report template. It comes with all the most important and popular metrics that most people will want to track, such as, you know, like, comment, top post, subscriber, engagement, and whatnot. So if you're looking to track only one social media at a time, like Facebook, there's some template that is already out there, you know, that's available. But I prefer to have one report with all of my data from all my social media page. That way I can easily compare them and get all the info that I need in one place. So I choose one that includes everything. I give it a super awesome McVille name. Because I'm from Canada, I'm gonna put it, you know, in Canada. Yeah, that's a Canadian accent you're hearing. And I can even choose, you know, a time period that fits the report time frame that I want my clients to be able to look at the data. We usually recommend a monthly period. It all depends on the campaign you're running, but a monthly period allows you to see the different strategy you might have used while also being able to provide, you know, meaningful data. Sometimes a day or a week might not be enough for you to track everything. Then again, it all depends on the campaign you're doing. Some e-commerce campaign can be really great for weekly reporting. It all depends on what you're trying to track, what's your goal. So for this case, I'm gonna choose a monthly period. Simply click next. And then if you want to add, you know, something, simply click on it. So if you're having, you know, predefined integration that you want to select from the template you've selected, you simply click on them and then you'll be able to have the data all gathered into one place. And what's fun is by selecting those integration, the tool is smart enough so that it'll aggregate every data from every source that you've selected. That means if I'm selecting more than one Facebook source, it'll create the widget from all those different sources. So I'll be able to aggregate all the data into widgets. So that's not the case right now. I want to do this only for a client, and I can even add also other integration. So maybe Google Analytics is something you'd like to showcase your clients, like the website analytics result of your social media campaign. So it's a great way, you know, to add more meaningful value to your campaign. So I'm simply going to select a source here and then create a dashboard. Boom! Super easy. I've connected the source that I want to use, and then I clicked on created. Man, I already have a meaningful report. Also, one of the main reasons I like to choose a template, it's not because I'm lazy, but it's because I'm lazy. You know, I already have headers, which are super important for the users. You know, it kind of drives you to where you're going, what I'm looking at. So it's really helpful. Also, those smart templates have been created thinking about the end user, so we put important metrics on top left, because people usually write from top left to bottom right. And your eyes will glance at the metric that has the most value first. Of course, that's just, you know, one size fits all kind of template. So what I usually recommend is to add custom metric. That way you'll be able to tailor this template to the campaign you're working on. So super easy, super simple, custom widget. Let's say that I want to show my Facebook history, you know, impressions. So I simply click on Facebook, select a metric. I can even type it, page impression, create the widget. And there we go, it has been populated. So super easy. I can, of course, you know, move things around, making sure this widget fits and is already into the proper section, which is quite important if you're asking me. So I'm just gonna put it over here. I know that I already have it. I just wanted to show you, you know, that you could also modify the look. So those are the same type of widget. It's what we call history. It's one of my favorite because it's so condensed and brings a lot of data. So I'm able to get, of course, the history, and I'm able to see a comparison. So from the previous period, the previous month, and from the previous year. So a year-over-year review straight from the widget. Super meaningful, super important. Clients usually like that. And a favorite part about this is that I can simply edit the widget so it looks, you know, different. Of course, making sure that you can, you know, tailor this report to something that feels either like your brand or your client's brand is even more meaningful. I do like this one, so I'm just gonna apply it. Perfect. We've added Google Analytics to this dashboard. It's maybe because we wanted to show how our social media campaign impact our website activity. Well, we can't simply do it. Then again, create a custom metric, custom widget, and select the Google Analytics source. That way, I'm gonna be able to simply select the metrics that I wanna show. If you're running, you know, a e-commerce campaign, maybe you wanna show, you know, a click-through rate, a conversion rate, or simply some sessions. So definitely all depend on what campaign you're trying to showcase. What are you trying to do with this campaign? Go with the metric that makes the most sense. Now, the one thing I would suggest when it comes to social media analytics is to be cautious and not to put too many vanity metrics here. Vanity metrics is being the data that isn't really aligned with your objective, but looks good and looks important. For example, if your goal is to drive e-commerce traffic and that you have campaign rollings on Facebook and Instagram, only those two platforms, well, you will want to showcase those two channels, especially, you know, post engagement, like metrics, comments, share, etc., and conversion, click-through rate, numbers of sale, traffic, bounce rate, etc. But you won't really need, you know, your number of LinkedIn followers, for example. You may be tempted to add it because it seems like a relevant metric for your social media report, but you need to stay focused and stay on target on what you're actively working on. So I'm gonna simply delete my LinkedIn section over here. It's gonna be much more meaningful. So make sure you only had relevant metric section, like, you know, Facebook Insights, Facebook Paid, Instagram. So showing only those sections is gonna make it super easy to understand, not only for you, but for your boss or your client as well. Once this all looked perfect, just add a couple of comments, you know. Maybe they don't know what's a click-through rate, so maybe they don't know what engagement here or, you know, post-reaction. So CTR here, what I could do is simply, you know, add a note. CTR means click rate. So being able to add a note or even comments, you know, like, I don't know, you can put, you know, I like to put silly stuff. So what I usually do is I kind of like to put, you know, my dog Oscar in it, just to showcase that, you know, you can be fun, put a lot of, you know, personality into your report, making sure also that, you know, you stay relevant, but you can, you know, be a bit silly, as I am, to, you know, keep your client's attention. So you've added your comments, you've added your silly, you know, a GIF or whatnot. Now you can simply, you know, schedule a share. What I usually like to do is making sure that this awesome dashboard is being said to Edward DashThis. Hey, and then, you know, this is a note. You can add a note. I do recommend including a full PDF version. That way you're kind of attaching an art copy of, you know, your report. And then I can set a frequency. Let's say I want this to be sent each, you know, a month, each fifth of the month, each sixth. Perfect. It is saved. Now I can go back and change the comments for the next period. I'll be good to go. So it's all done, nothing else to do. And you know, I don't have to kind of redo it again because it's an automated tool. Everything that I've placed, the note, changing the name of the widgets, it's all going to stay the same the next month. I won't have to go back and do it again. So if you'd like to try this social media template for yourself, I've put a link in the description below. So feel free to try it out. I hope you found this short video useful. Let me know what you'd like to see next in the comment section below. And of course, happy reporting.